In this video, I'm going to talk about Pathfinder tool, and Pathfinder tool is the most interesting tool of Illustrator. So where do you find Pathfinder? It's right in the panel doc at the bottom. So if you move your cursor here, it's there, right there. But just in case in your while working you're not able to see the Pathfinder, what you do is, like, suppose I just cross this. You can always go to Windows and just look for Pathfinder here. Just open it. So Pathfinder is something like, you know, so any tool you're not able to find, you can always go to the menu bar, go over Windows, and we have whole lot of tools here. So this one I took from Windows. So we're going to discuss Pathfinder here. So if I bring it in the center, so here we have two tools here, shape mode and Pathfinder. And in the shape mode there are four tools to be used, and in the Pathfinder you have six tools. So it is kind of overwhelming to kind of see a lot of tools, and eventually you will learn a lot of tools. But in fashion designing, I'm going to teach you three tools which we are going to use quite often. Now this one is the Unite tool, which is the first tool in the shape mode. And if I put my cursor here, it comes Unite, and then Exclude tool, which is the last of the shape mode, and the first one that is in the Pathfinder's first one is Divide. So I'm going to discuss all three. Okay, so let's see. I take a pencil tool and I try to draw a cloud like this, and I'm actually making a very bad cloud. Okay, now this happens quite a lot. So this is an error which happens. Now if I put my cursor around, you actually, like, you know, if I just marquee select it, my cloud is there. Otherwise it's like, if I click anywhere, the cloud is just like gone. So this is something you'll come across quite a bit, and you don't need to get so worried about it. All you have to do is marquee select it. This has happened because there is no fill and no stroke. I can click on the D key and bring back the cloud. Now this is the worst of worst clouds that I have made here. To make a very beautiful looking cloud, I would just take the ellipse tool, and this time I'll try to make a perfect cloud by trying to coincide these circles together. So couple of ellipses I'm taking, yeah, like this. And now I marquee select all of it. Just make sure you select all of it, and then use my first tool in the Pathfinder in the shape mode, which is Unite. When I click Unite, it gives me a very beautiful shape of the cloud, and I can color the cloud as well. Now let's say I want to put some holes in this cloud. So what I can do is I can take my ellipse tool again and just make some circles. Doesn't matter, it's small or large. And maybe I want to select. So I'm selecting all of these by clicking, holding on to my shift key. So, and I want to change the color, and the reason I want to change the color is just that I'm going to show to you. So here I marquee select everything. This time I'm going to use the exclude tool. So here is the exclude tool, just select it. Now this is actually, like, I've actually punched holes in my cloud. I can just go over here, and you can actually see I punched holes in my cloud. Now this tool is quite useful when you're making buttonholes or buttons, different kind of buttons. So this tool is very useful. Okay, now let's suppose I want to crack this cloud. So how do I crack this cloud? So I take my pen tool here and I crack this cloud like this. Now just remember, while making my pen tool, what happened was, I have a filling here. Now when you crack your cloud or divide your cloud, you should not be having a fill. So I should avoid a fill, and I'm going to tell you why I'm avoiding the fill. I'll just select all of this again, and I'm going to use my last tool, which is the divide tool in the Pathfinder, like this, and right click and ungroup. So basically you see this, it's divided. Now why I was telling you what will happen if you have a filling and then you use the divide tool. Now let me just show you the mistake. So I use my good old friend Control Z and I do couple of times. So this was my action before I unfilled it. So this is how it is. So let me just give it a color. Okay, now I'll select all of this and I will divide it and right click ungroup. So now you see it's actually taken the triangle also and it has divided it into various parts, which is something that you're not looking for. So just be sure that whenever you are dividing, you're using the just the stroke and not the filling. Now this is a very interesting exercise which I want you to practice. Since you've understood how to use the unite tool, the exclude tool and the divide tool, and all of them come in this. So let me just marquee select all of this and click the delete key. Now let me first make a circle, and I'll start from the center by clicking alt and shift because I want a perfect circle. And I want to duplicate the circle, so I will click Control C and Control F, and this time I want the circle to be smaller. The second circle that I pasted in the front has to be smaller, so I'm going to click on the circle and I'm going to click Alt and Shift together and just move my cursor from the corner to the center. So this is something that it kind of creates a ring, and I want to use the exclude key here. So I use my exclude key. So kind of created a ring. This is a ring that I've created. Now I'm going to duplicate the ring twice, or maybe at this time I'll just do it once, and I will give this a color. Now I want these rings to be kind of looking like a chain. So what I do is I select both of them and use my second tool, which is the divide tool. Now this is divided, but it is not actually divided, you know, it's not moving out, so it will not do anything unless you kind of right click and ungroup it. So the moment you right click and ungroup, this is how it's going to look like. So I'll just do Control Z again, and I've done that, and I'm going to just use my unite tool to select a certain part. Like I'm selecting this small rhombus here, select this portion, select this portion, and I'm going to use the unite key. And we change the color to the blue so that you can see the difference. Use this first, select the small rhombus, because it's always better to select the small rhombus and then use select the bigger sections. And I'm clicking shift to select all of them. So I'm clicking once, shift, I click shift again, and my shift again. So this is how I'm kind of selecting all of them together. And I will use my unite key. So this is a very interesting exercise where you can practice all the three tools. In the next movie, I'm going to tell you about a similar tool which is much more convenient, and Illustrator has brought that to make our life much more simpler. So that's the Shape Builder tool.